Income capital gain tax, remove the securities transaction tax, because it was very clearly mentioned that we are not going to charge you long-term capital gain. Only because of that you pay through securities transaction tax, number one. Number two, you could have, instead of doing that, you could have, instead of made the long-term capital gain eligibility, instead of 1 year to 2 years. So that could have been done. Now see what happens. You are promoting, in a way, you're trying to promote a casino culture. What do I mean by that? Short-term capital gain, 15%, long-term capital gain, 10%. Can you get what I'm saying? So what are you trying to do? Are you trying to tempt people to book profits more faster? Or are you asking them, no, you wait longer? Where is the patience? Where is the... See, stock market is something where... it's not me telling you. Today you go through radio jingles, investor protection funds, everybody is telling you. A parent is telling you. Invest karo, invest karo, nivesh karo, nivesh karo, SIP karo, right? And 22 lakh crores has come in. It's not a small sum. It's coming from hard-earned money. It's coming from everybody's savings. And why does it grow? It grows because this country is growing. Capital market is growing. And it's in everybody's interest that you hold on for more than a year and make your capital grow. Where else can you make your capital grow? So keeping that in mind, it should have been that you either have a securities transaction tax or abolish that and say, okay, fine. And we have done that in the past. We promised you that, and we're going ahead with this now. Thank you.
I can add, since he has got, I can add one or two points to what he said. See, at least I can understand STT and capital gains tax coexisting now, because that was promised by some other government, some other minister. What I'm not able to understand and comprehend is that fact that this corporate income tax reduction from 30 to 25 was promised by the same Mr. Arun Jaitley in Parliament, and again is not doing anything about it. That's where I have a problem. The second issue to that question asked by that learned lady is that this is only the beginning. This is only breakfast, 10% for above a lakh of rupees. The lunch will come at 15%, the dinner will come at 20% as we go along. So this is not the end of it. This is going to be a cow which is going to yield greater milk potential. So therefore, that is what I'm worried about. You can do a taxation, you can do a moderate taxation where there will be a lot of compliance and there will be people willing to pay. If you have a greedy approach, then you will have a problem later on.
Sir, I also want to respond to the learned person who said that budget should be an event and not a non-event. I was only referring to the fact that it should be basically something between the head of finance of a government and the legislators, and not necessarily for everybody to be bothered about. There should be some kind of a stability. So if we have a stable level of taxes, we have a stable level of policies by which investments are brought in and you grow, the countries which you were comparing, they all have stable systems. They don't have such an euphoria on budget day.
Is they developed, we are underdeveloped?
No, no. It's not necessarily so. Even when they were not developed, when Lee Kuan Yew was trying to bring up that country, they didn't have this euphoria. At that time, you were Nani Palkiwala every budget day holding forth. Before Singapore developed.
Again, on that STT and long-term capital gain. See, all of I think according to my this one, there is no connection between these two. Whatever the finance minister promised, because you are not paying LT long-term capital gains, you pay STT. That is maybe the passing reference, or maybe in the parliament it has said. But long-term capital gain tax 10% on the income, what do you earn? Whereas STT is on the transaction what you do. Now if I pay, if I would have bought the share about 5 years back of L&T, 1 lakh rupees I invested, I would have paid hardly 100 or 150 rupees or STT. And tomorrow if I want to sell that, I may get around 5 lakhs rupees, or I mean around 3 lakhs rupees, then I have to pay just 300, maybe 200 rupees as a STT. And government, what you see, there is no connection at all. It's a very small percentage. If every day, since the last 3 years, if I buy L&T, sell the same day, next day again buy, make profit, short term and all these things, Of course, the estate will be very huge. Every day, for every transaction, you have to pay tax. So connecting this STT to the 10% on the gain, there is no relevance according to me. I mean, with due respect to Mr. Mehta, right? There is no much connection. Yeah, thank you.
So let's close here. We are short on time. And I would like to thank each one of you to come. Each of the panelists has given their very best.